Okay, so let's talk about the different divisions or layers of the epidermis, and it's very dependent on where in the body you are. The majority of the epidermis is going to be four layers, whereas in the thick skin, you're going to have five layers. We're going to discuss all five layers, then we'll come back to the thin skin. Okay, so we have a few nice visuals here to have an understanding of where these are located, and as well as whether these cells within these layers are alive or dead. And before we go any further, I want to discuss apoptosis or cellular death. When you're talking about the epidermis, that is a normal, typical thing that happens. You lose skin cells from the most superficial layers, then you grow new skin cells that will move up and eventually be sloughed off. So very natural. It can speed up and be atypical, and we'll talk about some of those disorders at the end of this module. So when you're talking about thick skin is going to be located in two main areas of your body, on your palms and your digits, and then on the soles of your feet, as well as the digits associated with that portion of your foot. And when you're talking about the five layers of thick skin, we're gonna start from the deepest layer, your basale. We're gonna move up to spinosum, granulosum, lucidum, and corneum. Lucidum is only present in thick skin. Okay, so only in thick skin will you have the lucidum layer. The layers in the deepest are going to be round and alive and capable of reproducing and creating more cells. And then the layers in the more superficial portions are all going to be flat and dead. So pretty much from granulosum up. Now this is a time that you want to start thinking about mnemonics. Mnemonics are huge, particularly in anatomy. There is a lot of memorization in anatomy, so whatever works for you, I'll put up a few options in different areas when I'm discussing, particularly when I talk about musculoskeletal anatomy. But now is the time to start coming up with your own mnemonics to help you memorize certain things. Okay, so here we are in terms of the same visual that we've been looking at in previous modules. This is going to be the deepest part of the epidermis, your stratum basale, and then we're going to move more superficially to the stratum corneum. Right underneath here is your dermis, so the deepest part of the skin layer. All right, so the deepest layer is the stratum basale. This is unique in the fact that it is a single layer of skin. So we only have one layer of cells here. This is unique. We're not going to have this in any of the other divisions. And also you have different types of cells. The majority of the other layers are going to be composed of almost exclusively keratinocytes. But in the stratum basale, you can have melanocytes, you can have those Merkel cells that are meeting up with these neurons. And then you can have Langerhans cells associated with basale as well. Now this area is going to create new cells. So you're going to have stem cells associated with the basale. So you have the continual creation of new cells which will eventually move more superficially. Okay, now moving a little more superficially from the stratum basale, you're going to have the stratum spinosum. And this is going to be numerous layers of keratinocytes, almost exclusively. You can have your melanocyte processes moving into this area, as well as those macrophage Langerhans cells, but the majority are going to be those keratinocytes that are still able to divide and have the creation of new keratinocytes. Now, this name seems kind of confusing, and it's all because of histology. So when they were creating slides, these cells would kind of dry up and appear spiny. But when you're actually thinking about a living individual, these cells are actually quite robust and quite large in comparison to these other layers. Now, the intermediate layer, when you're talking about the thick skin, is the stratum granulosum. And this is a very important area because this is the transition layer. Some of the cells in this layer are alive, whereas some of the cells are undergoing apoptosis or programmed cell death. So you can have alive and dead cells in the granulosum. Now in thick skin only, you have the stratum lucidum. And this is a fairly nondescript layer. It usually is 3 to 5 layers of cells thick, and it's just composed of dead keratinocytes. So you'll only have these in the thick skin, so the palms of your hand and the soles of your feet. And lastly, in the most superficial layer, so what you can actually see on other individuals and yourself, is the stratum corneum. Now, depending on what area of the body you're in, this is variably thick, but these are all going to be dead, flattened, or squamous keratinocytes. And actually, in this layer here, these keratinocytes have a unique name, corneocytes. So this is the thicker, the flat keratinocytes in this region. So depending on the area of the body, this can be between 5 layers to up to 50 cell layers thick. So if you think of the palms of your hand, you're going to have a much more substantial stratum corneum. Now, it usually takes about 4 weeks from keratinocytes to be developed in the stratum basale and move superficially to the stratum corneum. But certain things can speed that up. Abrasions, cuts, burns can speed up that process. And then in certain disorders, similar to psoriasis. So this is a chronic skin disorder where keratinocytes divide and are produced more quickly and move up superficially faster than in a typical individual. And what will happen is you're going to have the creation of what's referred to as plaque. So it'll appear almost white, scaly-like, and then you can have some redness or inflammation associated with those skin cells as well. So what happens is that these cells don't go through the proper developmental process. It goes a little too fast, and you do not have the typical corneocyte that you would have in most individuals in the stratum basale, or stratum corneum, excuse me. Now, dandruff is actually very similar to this, but it's located solely within the scalp. So that is a quick overview in terms of the epidermal layers. Now we're going to move into the deeper dermis. This actually is only composed of 2 layers, so that one will go a little bit fast, but when we think about the dermis, it's actually quite a bit more complex than what we have in the epidermis.